We don't know the actual location of the fabled cities of Sodom and Gomorrah, but keep in mind that this is not a literal story or actual historical event. The translation of the Hebrew words Sodom for Sodom and Gomorrah for Gomorrah actually translates literally to scorched and ruined heap. This is a parable. In the story, Abraham was able to see the destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah from his home. Genesis chapter 19 verses 27 and 28. Early the next morning, Abraham got up and returned to the place where he had stood before the Lord. He looked down toward Sodom and Gomorrah, toward the land of the plain, and he saw dense smoke rising from the land, like smoke from a furnace. We know Abraham's home was in Hebron. Genesis chapter 13 verse 18. So Abram moved his tents and went to live near the great trees of Mamre at Hebron, where he built an altar to the Lord. It is worth noting that Mamre was an Amorite king allied with Abraham, Genesis chapter 14 verse 13. Mamre is translated into English as strength or fatness. We also know that Lot's home was near Sodom and that Abraham and Lot parted ways on amicable terms. Lot is Abraham's nephew, Genesis chapter 13 verse 12. Abram lived in the land of Canaan, while Lot lived near the cities of the plain and pitched his tents near Sodom. Hebron is about at the midway point of the Dead Sea, so it cannot be determined from the story if Sodom and Gomorrah were on the north or the south end of the Dead Sea. The cities destroyed were Sodom, Gomorrah, Admah, Zeboam, the cities of the plains as per the story, but Zoar was spared at the request of Lot, Genesis chapter 19, verses 20 and 21. The location of the biblical Sodom has been speculated to be Babadra in Jordan, but this is not overly important as the land was the land of the Canaanites, and the importance of this will become evident. It is also worth noting that Abraham did plead for the saving of Sodom in Genesis chapter 18, as God did tell Abraham that he was going to wipe out the city. Abraham replied, "Will you sweep away the righteous with the wicked?" Verse 23. Hence the reason why God sent two angels with Lot. Was the so-called crime of Sodom and Gomorrah homosexuality as per Christian doctrine? According to the ancient Jewish philosopher Philo of Alexandria, the people of Sodom and Gomorrah were engaging in unnatural sexual practices with unnatural lust towards women and men mounting men. Flavius Josephus made similar claims, but we will revisit these so-called abominations. As per Jewish doctrine, the crime was the inhospitable nature of the people of Sodom and Gomorrah, crimes which included setting up circumstances that would deny beggars access to food, lack of compassion, and barbaric treatment of guests. As per this version of the legend, two women were put to death for their generosity. One was Peltith, the daughter of Lot. She was burned to death. The other girl, who goes unnamed, was covered with honey and eaten by bees. For those of you who are not aware, bees are herbivores, or more specifically, paleonivores. That is, they eat pollen from flower-bearing and seed-bearing plants, not flesh, unless there's an undiscovered species of flesh-eating bee located somewhere in the Middle East in the area of the Dead Sea. As per the Islamic version, the people of Sodom and Gomorrah were told to mend their evil ways, and again the so-called abomination of homosexuality is implied. And his people came rushing towards him, and they had long been in their habits of practicing abominations. He said, "O my people, here are my daughters, they are purer for you, if ye marry. Now fear Allah, and cover me not with shame about my guests. Is there not among you a single right-minded man?" They said, "Well, dost thou know, we have no need for thy daughters. Indeed, thou knowest quite well what we want." Other accusations include gambling, the use of intoxicants, the eating of forbidden meat, but again, was the supposed crime homosexuality? The answer is no. The second book of Enoch makes the following claim regarding Sodom and Gomorrah. "And all those men said to me, 'This place, O Enoch, is prepared for those who dishonor God, who on earth practice such sin against nature, which is child corruption after the Sodomitic fashion, magic making, enchantments, and devilish witchcrafts, and those who boast of their wicked deeds, stealing, lies, calumnies, envy, rancor, fornication, and murder.'" It does need to be stated that the second book of Enoch is apocalyptic in nature and likely written in the late 1st century CE. It was a time of apocalyptic claims, by Jewish authors, likely of Greek origin, so it is not to be considered part of the Old Testament scripture, but it does set the stage of what the commonly held thought was in the first century when comparing to Jewish and Christian text, then followed up by the later Islamic text a few hundred years later. Overall, the Sodomites, as per these texts, were considered barbaric, sexually depraved, and immoral, but the second book of Enoch does give hints at child corruption, murder, and dishonoring God. Today, the term sodomy is defined as anal or oral copulation with a member of the same or opposite sex, It also includes copulation with animals, so this defines what a sodomite was. Or maybe not. A closer look at the Hebrew scripture reveals the word used for sodomite, and that is the word kadesh, which has nothing to do with the word Sodom or Sodom. Kadesh translates not as a person who engages in anal or oral copulation with another person or copulation with an animal. It translates as another set of words, or more precisely, an occupation, that of the male temple prostitute. As mentioned in my two-part video on Lilith, the cultures of the area included the Canaanites and the Hebrews, and the practices of these people included fertility rituals. These rituals were directed towards the gods of the polytheistic cultures. Gods and goddesses such as Baal, Moloch, and Aftart, and these rituals were intended to promote fertility for the continuation of life. Some of these practices also included child sacrifice, which included the burning of the body, as it was believed that the firstborn child diminished the power of the gods, so the power had to be returned. This should be a reminder of when God demanded Abram, later named Abraham, to sacrifice his firstborn child Isaac on Mount Moriah. The reason for the name change from Abram to Abraham is not applicable to this video, but it is worth noting that Abraham had two wives, Sarai and Hagar. Sarai gave Abram her Egyptian maidservant Hagar as a second wife, Genesis chapter 16 verse 1, because Sarai did not conceive. Genesis chapter 22 verse 2. And he said, "Take now thy son, thine own son Isaac, whom thou lovest, and get thee into the land of Moriah, and offer him there for a burnt offering upon the mountains which I will tell of thee." Moriah is referenced only in one other place in the Bible, 2 Chronicles chapter 3 verse 1, the building of the Temple of Solomon. The Amorites are one of the Canaanite tribes, along with the Jebusites, Hittites, and so on in a biblical sense, and biblical scholars agree that Mount Moriah is likely translated as Mount of the Amorites, as in Hebrew the word Moriah comes from the root Emori, which translates to mountaineers or mountain dwellers, which is who the Amorites were. The Akkadians considered what is Syria and Canaan to be the land of the Amorites, and we have tablets dating from the 22nd century BCE to indicate this is the case. The Akkadians considered the area of Jabal Bishiri in Syria as Mount of the Amorites. However, the Bible places this area in Jerusalem as per 2 Chronicles chapter 3 verse 1, which likely is referring to the southern slopes of the mountains of Judea. Hebron is in Judea, in the west bank of modern-day Israel, the land of the Amorites. Referring back to Genesis chapter 22 verse 2, it is very possible that Abraham was performing a fertility ritual, though admittedly this is speculation. These fertility rituals sometimes contain a homoerotic element to them, and the participation in polytheistic practices is forbidden in the worship of Yahweh. Exodus chapter 20 verse 3 from the Ten Commandments. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. In the story of Sodom and Gomorrah, the angels are approached by a group of kadesh, that is, male temple prostitutes, who exist in cultures that practice fertility rituals. The group wants to know these two men or have them engage in sexual activities with temple prostitutes. They want these angels to participate in a fertility ritual. The issue is not homosexuality, it is idolatry, the worship of false gods. The story of Sodom and Gomorrah is being misrepresented to promote a homophobic agenda. It is also interesting that in 1 Chronicles chapter 12 verse 5, it mentions the word Baalia. This translates to Yahweh is Baal.